more abundantly. Shake somebody's hand and say, I want them back. I want them back. I want my pretty little girl to have a life. I want my son to have a life. I want my grandchildren to have a life. And it's time to shake up. Get up. Take your anointing. Step in the street and tell the enemy, get off of my son. Get off of my child. Can I preach like a fillet? Used to be mamas had nerves. I feel like preaching in here. Used to be mamas was something to reckon with. Would walk into a gang and tell her son, get home. I dare you to stand around here. But we have tried to be popular with our children. I wish I could preach to somebody in here. We try to be popular. I feel like shouting. You can't smoke dope with your child and expect him to respect you. I might as well quit. I might as well. Because I feel the Holy Ghost. You can't salute with a 15-year-old and drinking gin and expect them to listen. You gotta set a standard in the house. Can I preach like I feel it? You can't be 55 and got your dress up to here and trying to tell your daughter how to operate in the house. You can't, you can't, you can't. You gotta walk in there like you're a matron and let that child know, I'm running this house and it's either my way or the highway. It's either what I want, cause I'm paying the bills up in this house. You can't let your boys come in all time of night. I feel like preaching in here. Set a curfew. Tell them get in here and clean your nasty room. You can't let them drive you crazy, cause they're driving everybody crazy. I'd rather go past 10 men than 3 boys, because they've got guns at 14 years old. I feel like preaching in here. Get the guns out of their hand. Put a book in their hand. Get the guns out of their hand. Put an organ in their hand. Get the guns out of their hand. Put a computer in their hand. I'm getting ready to close, but I feel like somebody ought to holler, Lord, give them back. Give them back to us. Give them back with a better spirit. Give them back with a better mind. Give them back with a better attitude. The Bible said when he touched him, he said, young man, arise. They need to arise out of poverty. Arise out of negativity. Arise out of slavery. Arise out of evil. Arise out of madness. Arise. Come up out of there. Come up out of there. In the name of Jesus. Somebody holler, I want them back. I want them back. Can I get some help just for one more time? Give somebody a high five and say, neighbor, let's roll up our sleeves and let's take them back. God told us that we ought to take it back. Take it back. Tell the devil, it's my child. It's my home. And I want the child back. Thank you. Two enemies met that day. Life and death. And the Lord promised us that death is going to be the last enemy that's going to be conquered. But we don't need to be in a wonderful environment and it be a burying ground. I'm closing. Some of our children in this community have lived here for 15, 16, 17, 18 years and shot down and never saw the beach. Would you believe that they've lived in these communities and never been to the water? And I said to myself, when I was coming to California, I said, I would have to have a house somewhere in California that when I open my eyes, I know where I am. That's why I can't live in certain parts of Beverly Hills. Because I open my eyes, I might as well be in Atlanta, Georgia. There is no distinction. Amen. When I open my eyes, I want to know where I'm living at. So I have to see some water. Now, but I want every child to have their opportunity to be able to live wherever they choose. And it is incumbent upon us now to ask the Lord to intervene. And all of us have to confess that we have dropped the ball. And the reason we need to recover it is because we messed it up. In closing, I want you to be happy going out the door. But I tell people all the time, I say, you know, in relationships, you know, you're rapping a little bit. And they say, well, you know, the reason we not getting along right through here, because see, I wasn't raised to be with you. I wasn't raised to be with you. And people take offense at that. I wasn't raised to be with you. I didn't even know you were coming. I didn't even know I'd ever meet you. So how could I plan to be with you? If I knew you were coming and we were going to get this close, I'd have asked my mama to raise me so I could fit you. Amen. I'd send her a message and tell my daddy, Daddy, I'm going to meet so-and-so 20 years from now. Raise me so we can make it. And then I'll send word to you and you tell your mama and daddy so that we can be raised to be with each other. Now, to make the point, I say to people, we can't get along because we were raised differently. But now, notice something, and then we have to stretch, and we have to compromise, and we have to see compatibility. We have to work it out. Relationships call for a lot of work. Amen. I talk about you in love. Love is a job. I didn't mean it like that, but it came out that way. To make the point, to relate to our disparity in relationships, I bring up children. And I say to many parents, or to make the point, you gave birth to a child who came in here literally blank. Amen. They were in your hand to be molded. And 15 years later, you don't like them. You wondering how come you can't get along with me And I'm wondering how come you raise a child and 20 years later, you don't want to see him. They were in your hands. I'm simply saying that the problem out here, we are responsible. And the reason we ought to roll our sleeves up and get back in the race is because we owe our communities the opportunity to live before they're buried. And I'm glad that Jesus timed it just right. And so everything that's happening is to stimulate you and I to get back in the race and get back to touching people. If you're in this building right now, the Lord is calling you. And he's saying it's time to be saved. It's time to join the army that's going to change the world. Come on. You know the song that I need you, you need, we're all part of God's family, you know, I should listen to God. Come on. Come on. Young man, young lady, God's calling you. Come on. Bring the whole family. You to survive. Oh, what a truth, what a song. Whoever wrote that for this hour.
Survive.